morning, dear brothers and sisters in the Catholic faith. My name is Admin Jess again, and I'm sorry if it took me a long time to create another video again. So, ito na po. Before we start, ito pong shirt na suot ko ngayon is a Catholic faith defense shirt. The first one is our first logo, and then the second logo, and then the third logo. So, we have a current logo now, bago na naman to. Kumbaga, one of the admins, I think it's Admin Peter, minix niya yung tatlong logo. So, I think yun na yung profile namin ngayon, so you better check. This is a statement shirt. It says, are you Catholic or a Christian? And then, ang sabi dito, I am Catholic and so I am a Christian. Catholics are the first, are the original Christians actually. So, itong dito, nandito is, I think this is the verse already. It's Matthew 28:19-20, wherein it says, Jesus promised to be with his church until the end of the age. The Catholic Church is the true church, so it can never go wrong in terms of doctrinal matters. So yun po yung sinasabi ng t-shirt. Okay, so for today's video, our topic would be dealing with an atheist. So as we all know, dear brothers and sisters, atheists are the most difficult persons to deal with in terms of convincing them to believe in the existence of God. Because these people have, I think, bad experiences wherein they did not feel the presence of God and on how God worked on their lives. So kaya hindi sila naniniwala sa Diyos gawa ng meron nga silang mga medyo hindi makagandang experiences. And I think many of atheist people out there are dating mga religious, dating mga maka-Diyos who lost their faith to God. Actually, I when I started in the BPO industry, there was this trainer, I really find her good. But I learned that she doesn't believe in God. She would always tell me na everything, the food I eat, the water I drink, I pay for it. And even the rice I eat, it comes from the farmers. And everything that you ask to her, she wouldn't really believe that there is God. And when I asked what happened or what led her to not believe that there is God, so she told a story about her life. I'm not going to talk much about it kasi baka hindi pwede. And it's her private life. But just to give you a hint, dumating sila sa point na naghirap wherein lumapit sila sa church and they were rejected. So, yun. So, wala naman perfecto ng mga member ng simbahan eh. The church is always perfect, but the members are not. So, meron siyang negative experience with a church servant. Sabi ko nga sa kanya, parang dapat lumapit siya sa pare. Eh kasi parang normal servant lang yung nilapitan niya during that time. So let's go back. So yun nga, ang pag-uusapan natin, how to deal with an atheist. Just a couple of days ago, I had an encounter with a professional guy. And for us to be able to deal with an atheist, dapat mamili din tayo sa isang atheist na maayos kausap. Kasi meron mga atheist na war freak or yung wala sa ano lugar yung logic nila. So para maiwasan din natin yung madadala tayo ng galit, which will eventually lead us into sin, yun, it's important for us to deal with an atheist who is professional, and I'm blessed to encounter this professional atheist. So he gave me this verse, Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11. Ang sabi dito, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. So ang sabi niya, if God's plans for me are good and for my benefit, why am I broken and down? So I never asked more about his problem. So ang dinil ko, I focused on answering his questions. So ang sabi ko, hey brother, dapat kasi, ito lang mga kapatid, mga ka-CF Defense, it is always important for us people to acknowledge God's presence in everything we do. What does it mean? For example, kapag meron kang a-apply ang trabaho, ask for God's grace. Lord, I will be in an interview later. Sana po gabayan niyo ako sa pagsagot ko. And your will be done po, and not mine. So, because when we do, when we acknowledge God to be with us in everything that we do, we could never go wrong. Mahalaga yun. In everything that we do, especially if it's for our own good, like for example, finding a job, looking for a job, going to an interview, then why not try to acknowledge God? God, Lord, be with me. Teach me sa dapat kong sabihin. Turuan mo po ako, Lord, kung ano mga dapat kong sabihin. Na sana makuha ko or makapasa ako. And don't worry about it. God will take care of the rest. Yun lang naman ang ibig kong sabihin. Kaya sabi ko sa kanya, have you acknowledged God in everything that you do? If not, then maybe it's the reason. You decided on your own without involving Him in your plans. So, ang sagot niya sa akin, but if His plans are good and if He knows what is going to happen in the future, why does He allow me to be in this situation? This means that this is His plan. If God sees the future, why didn't He change the situation? So, these are questions from people who have bad experiences wherein they try to question God. Lord, kung ikaw Diyos, kung totoong Diyos ka, if you really see everything, and if you know my future, and if you know that if your plans for me are good, bakit ganun? Bakit ako nakulong? Bakit ako namatayan? Bakit ako nagkasakit? So, the perfect answer with that for that would be, it's not right to question why God allowed you to be in jail, why God allowed you to be sick, why God allowed you to be in a worse situation. Kasi, it's an insult to God, ang sabi ko sa kanya, it's an insult to God to associate miserable things that is happening in your life. It's an insult to God. Sabi ko sa kanya, remember, Adam and Eve, our first parents, God made a perfect paradise for Adam and Eve. Only God knows what is right and wrong, sabi ko sa kanya. It's only God. Back then, during the time of creation, it was only God who knows about what is right and what is wrong. God created a perfect paradise for us. But then, there is free will. Free will is not called free will kung lahat is kukontrolin ng Diyos sa atin. So sabi niya, then hindi nga siya Diyos who takes control of everything. Then He is not God who takes control of everything. Because again, if He sees that I am in the wrong path, He should have changed the situation. So sabi niya sa akin, kung Diyos siya na control niya ang lahat, bakit hindi niya binago yung sitwasyon? Okay. So, sabi ko sa kanya, again, when dealing with atheists like this, the perfect answer would be, it would be weird if someone will jump off the cliff, tatalon ka sa bangin, tapos hindi ka mamamatay, and then sasaksakin mo yung tao, tapos yung sinaksak mo walang sugat. Diba? Dun ko nakita na yun ang gusto niya mangyari. Sinaksak mo yung tao, yung sinaksak mo walang sugat. So he wanted to change, he wanted God to change the situation. sabi ko sa kanya, ini-expect mo na iinom ka ng alak, tapos later on, pag nalasing ka na, papatay ka ng tao, at gusto mo para hindi ka makapatay ng tao na yun is biglang maglaho yung alak. That is what you expected God to do in your life. Biglang mag-disappear yung alak at biglang imagic ni Lord na biglang mawala yon para lang hindi mangyari na malasing ka at makapatay ka eventually. Yun ang sabi ko sa kanya. Napakasi yung ganung katwiran, it's really absurd. It's really illogical or it's really shallow or petty. Kasi, yun ang gusto niyang control. Eventually, nasabi ko nga sa inyo mga kapatid, free will, that is the gift of God the Father. We should not expect God to remove the consequences of our actions. Unang-una, bakit ba tayo nakagawa ng kasalanan? Once we do a sin, there is always a consequence. You committed a sin, and so you have to expect that there is a consequence for that. You committed the sin and then you're going to expect and we are going to expect na walang consequences? Mali po yun. Gusto mo manapak ng tao tapos yung sinapak mo hindi masasaktan. Diba? Yun yung nakikita kong control na gusto niya. Nag-drugs ako pero hindi ako nalulong sa droga. Or nag-drugs ako, biglang tinanggal ni Lord yung drugs, biglang naglaho. That is the expectation of that particular professional atheist that I encountered. Well, mga kapatid, mali po ganun ang i-expect natin sa Diyos. Kasi if that is what we are going to experience or to expect from God, nasaan yung free will? Diba? If God controls everything that is happening in our lives, like, diba, wawalain niya yung alak, nanaksakan ng tao, hindi na saksak yung tao, or hindi na matay, or hindi man lang nasugatan, it contradicts our free will. Sabi niya, then He should remove free will, sabi niya sa akin. If He created goodness, bakit merong serpent doon sa Garden of Eden? If He created everything in the paradise, then He created the devil too. And it's really a hard question to answer. Kasi before I was even thinking na, oh nga no, if God created everything, then why does Satan exist? Bakit nag-i-exist ang demonyo? So, God led me to an answer. Sabi ko sa kanya, bro, God created everything. Mga kapatid, lagi nating tatandaan, God creating everything good in the Garden of Eden during the time of creation. With regards po dun sa serpent na nagtempt kay Adam and Eve to eat of the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, sinasabi dun sa scripture na, malinaw dun sa scripture na meron talagang actual na serpent in the Garden of Eden. At yun ay dinidescribe as one of the wild animals that God has created. But in some way, that serpent was used by the devil or was used by Satan to tempt Adam and Eve. Therefore, si Satan yung nasa likod ng personage or si yung diablo yung nasa likod ng pag-tempt nung ating unang mga magulang which is Adam and Eve through the serpent. God created the serpent, not the devil. Magkaiba po yun kasi Satan used the serpent. And then, the serpent was the instrument the devil used to do his act of tempting Adam and Eve. So, for that particular scenario, we can conclude na yung nagtempt ay yung devil na nagdisguise in the form of a serpent. So, ang sabi sa akin nung atheist, so God indeed created the devil. So sabi ko, no, God did not create the devil, or nor God created Satan. He did not create Satan. Kasi, at first, Satan was an angel, a creation or a good creation, who later on rebelled against God. Bakit ba siya nagrebelde? He want to be like God. So sabi niya, so why allow an angel to rebel against him? Isn't it more of a drama? So sabi ko sa kanya, no, hindi po yun. Try to understand this. So I gave him an analogy. Sabi ko, try to understand this. If God will control even the actions of the people by making it all just good, kung lahat ko kontrolin ng Panginoong Diyos at gagawin niyang maganda lang lahat, isipin natin mga kapatid, we will all be worshiping God kasi kinokontrol na tayo para maging mabuti. So kung lahat tayo kukontrolin ng Diyos para maging mabuti at sasamba tayo dahil lang kinokontrol niya tayo, napaka-awkward nun at napaka-weird nun. Kasi, kaya lang naman natin siya wino-worship kasi kinokontrol tayo ng Diyos. And God is not a controlling God. He is not a God that will force you. He is not a God who will force us to do the bad things. Yun ang sinabi ko sa kanya. Sabi ko sa kanya kung nagigets pa niya yung point ko. Like, brothers and sisters, it would be like really weird for God if we praise and worship Him just because He is controlling us to worship and praise Him. Praising and worshiping God is an act of goodness. And because we are expecting God to control our actions, we will be worshiping and praising Him. And if God does that expectation from that particular atheist, it would be weird for God to parang, kaya ka lang naman sinasamba ng mga tao na yun kasi kinokontrol mo eh. Kaya ka lang naman pinupuri ng mga tao na yun kasi kinokontrol mo sila. And God is not like that. Diba? For example, para kasing, parang ikaw lang nagsasabi sa parang sinasabi mo, yung ganung situation is like, you asking your friend to praise you, uy, purihin mo naman ako. Diba? So it's more on that or more about it. And to worship God out of our free will is more reasonable. Like for example, you worship and praise God and you do His will. Just because you will it, willingness mo, without God controlling you, without God forcing you to do it, it is much more reasonable. It is much more soothing in the ears to listen to. Mas maganda siyang pakinggan. Kaya mo sinasamba yung Panginoon, pinupuri mo siya, kasi kagustuhan mo na ayon sa kalooban natin. Without God forcing you to do it. Without God telling you what to do. So that's how God is. And sabi ko sa kanya, i-consider mo to bro. Meron kang anak. Malaya siyang gawin ang lahat. Pero pinipili niyang gawin yung tama kasi sabi ko sa kanya, pinipili niyang gawin yung tama kasi yung mga payo mo sa kanya ay sinusunod niya. Yung mga payo na makakabuti sa kanya, yung mga payo mo na makakabuti sa kanya, na alam niyang makakabuti sa kanya, ay sinusunod niya. Hindi mo siya pinipilit, winarningan mo lang siya na, o anak, pagka ganito yung gawin mo, ito yung mangyayari. So don't do it, anak. Nag-advise ka na huwag gawin, and then your son chooses to do it kasi nilalagay niya sa puso yung mga payo mo. And that's good. I-compare mo doon sa isang bata na kaya niya lang ginagawa yung mga bagay na yon kasi pinipilit mo siya. Kapag hindi mo ginawa, susuntukin kita. May mga ganong magulang, napaka-controlling eh. And if God is really a controlling God, then magiging parang magulang ng masyadong controlling yun eh. What happens to their kids? Naglilihim, nagtatago, nagwawala, nagiging mas naliligaw yung mga bata. So see, yun po yung pinapoint out ko sa kanya. So sabi ko sa kanya, kapag ginagawa ng tao yung isang bagay dahil pinipilit siya, that is not freedom. It contradicts free will. Kasi, God's creation was given the gift of freedom or free will. Binigyan tayo ng malaya kalayaan na gawin ang mga bagay ng naaayon sa gusto natin. So sabi niya, what about the temptation in the Garden of Eden? Sabi ko, ang problema dun sa temptation sa Garden of Eden was not Eve and Adam, not the serpent, and not the two trees. Ano ba yung dalawang puno na yon? It was the tree of life and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. So hindi si Adam ang problema, hindi si Eve, hindi yung dalawang puno. Kasi Adam and Eve were punished not just because of their disobedience, but they tried to be like God. Just like Satan, who rebelled against God, who wanted to be equal with God. That is what Adam and Eve did. It was not just pure disobedience, but the bigger picture is they wanted to be like God. Kasi if we are going to read the Bible dun sa temptation, the serpent told them na kapag kinain nyo tong prutas na to, you will be like him. Diba? Kasi, again, mga kapatid, it was only God back then who knows about what is good and evil. Adam and Eve doesn't know about it. Actually, they were naked. Totally naked. Okay? And then, sabi niya, but why did he allow temptation to succeed? Bakit hinayaan ng Diyos na mag-succeed yung temptation? Sabi ko sa kanya, again bro, weird po yun kapag sinunod natin ng Diyos dahil kinukontrol tayo. Sabi ko, freedom is doing what we want. True freedom is choosing what is right. Free will does not mean choosing what is not right. Adam and Eve were actually not tempted for what they do not know. If we are going to think about it, mga kapatid or mga ka-CF defense, Adam and Eve were tempted for something that they know. So we should appreciate that fact na hindi sila tinempt nung Diablo sa isang bagay na hindi nila alam. Kasi God warned them. Diba nga sabi ng ama, don't, you can eat everything in here, pero huwag kayong kakain dito sa isang puno na to. Diba? So, we can see in that particular event that God was able to warn Adam and Eve. So, hindi nagkulang yung Diyos. The Father did not lack at all. He created everything perfectly. He warned Eve and Adam and even pictured out what was going to happen. Sabi pa nga ng Diyos, if you eat of this fruit, you will die. Adam and Eve were curious what led to their disobedience, what led to Adam and Eve trying to be like God was their curiosity. Kasi, kumbaga, yung tree of life, it simply gives them health at meron na sila nun eh. Pero what the tree of knowledge of good and evil offers is something na hindi pa nila na-experience. Kaya Adam and Eve was curious what is going to happen if she tries to eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Diba, yun ang ano natin, kahit tayo mismo mga tao, yun ang inaano natin eh. Yun ang hinahanap natin. Kung ano yung meron tayo, hindi natin na-appreciate yun kasi na-experience na natin eh. Kung ano yung wala pa sa atin, yun yung pinapangarap natin makuha. And that is what happened to Eve, who then later on gave the fruit to Adam. Mga Catholic friends, mga Catholic brothers and sisters, mga ka-CF defense, tanggalin po natin sa isip natin na apple yung prutas. Hindi po yun apple. If you have kids and you are trying to teach them, do not say that the fruit was an apple. It's not an apple. Hindi po yun apple. Okay? So marami kasi mga Catholic parents yata is tinuturo sa kanilang mga anak na the fruit was apple. It's not correct. Okay? It's incorrect po. So, ang gusto ko lang pong sabihin dito mga kapatid, in dealing with people who do not believe in the existence of God just because they have this hard battle natalo sila, that they lost the fight, they lost the battle, we should not be blaming God. Kasi God, if we are going to say na God created evil, no. Again po, sasabihin ko sa inyo mga kapatid, God did not create evil. God did not create Satan. Kasi again, Satan was an angel back then who nagrebelde siya sa Diyos. So hindi natin pwedeng sabihin na Diyos ang gumawa nun, Diyos ang gumawa ng demonyo. No, kasi initially that the Satan was an angel back then who tried to rebel against God. So malinaw po yun mga kapatid, do not think that God created Satan. God did not create Satan, He created angels. So kung hindi siya nag-create ng demonyo, bakit si Satan nag-i-exist? Satan was a good creation of God back then. He is an angel who rebelled against God. Pero bakit nga ba inalaw ng Diyos na mag-rebelde ang isang anghel sa kanya? Again, babalik po tayo din sa sagot. Kasi if God controls everything, then He is not God. He must have created robots na sumusunod according to what He does, what He wants us to do. And again, God is not a controlling God. Hindi tayo puppet. Sabi ko nga kanina, sasambahin natin yung Diyos dahil lang kinokontrol tayo ng Diyos. It's like God creating puppets and robots. Sambahin niyo ako. Kinokontrol kita. Sambahin mo ako. Well, that is not God. That is not the true description of God. Itong mga verse na to, the Lord reigns from conception to death, Psalm 139, verses 11 to 16. The Lord reigns over every area of your life in the 3 John chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. And then the Lord reigns over events and history in Zechariah chapter 1, verses 1 to 4, and then verse 14. If we are going to read these verses, we can see that God is supreme over us, but He is not a forcing God. If you don't want to do His will, He is not gonna force you. For He has given us free will. We already have knowledge about evil and good, and that is enough. It was actually through Adam and Eve that we know it when they ate of the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. So dati, kaya nga nung nabuksan yung mga mata nila, nagtakip sila eh. Si Adam and Eve, they realized na hala, they were naked. And so they covered their naked bodies with the leaves of the plants in the Garden of Eden. So iisipin natin, bakit kaya hinayaan ng Diyos? Babalik tayo dun sa punto. Hindi po kasi controlling si Lord. He warned Adam and Eve not to eat of that particular tree, but then they did. Because they were curious of what is going to happen. They did not appreciate what the tree of life gives them or offers. Kasi na-experience na nila, again, but what the tree of knowledge of good and evil offers is something hindi pa nila nasusubukan. That's why they did. Okay? So I hope we learned something from this. And don't forget to share this video. Maraming salamat mga ka-CF Defense. If you want to get a shirt, just PM our page for more details. Again, this is Brother Jess. Maraming salamat po sa panonood.
Maraming salamat mga ka-CF Defense sa 2 taong samahan ng katotohanan sa inang simbahan.